It is very early in the morning and the air is very cold here at Kerosene Creek, a natural hot spring near Rotorua on the North Island of New Zealand. It's a natural swimming pool and waterfall at a warm and comfortable bathing temperature year-round because of the geothermal activity that's around here. There is also a questionable smell in the air, but fortunately that doesn't really come across on camera. This place is not the local secret that it used to be. Tourists flock here now, which is why I'm filming here so early. I didn't really want to turn up to a swimming pool full of people and awkwardly point a camera at them. But there's one view that I can show you that the tourists won't get to see, because there's a rule here that the government warnings are very clear about. Keep your head above water.
The brain-eating amoeba can be found in hot pools and things like that. So these organisms enter the nose. If you put your head under or you snort the water in, they can then go from the nose through the olfactory nerves to the brain. And then once in the brain, they start to eat the neurons and astrocytes, and they cause massive inflammation. And then you get this horrible amoeboid disease. It starts sometimes with a change in your sense of smell or sense of taste. And then that can progress to headaches, vomiting, fever, and then ultimately to seizures and death. There are potentially a couple of drugs that are used, one of which is not licensed for use and is actually very difficult to get hold of. So in general, there is no treatment and 97% of people die.
Brain-eating amoeba aren't unique to here or even to New Zealand. They're common anywhere that there's warm, untreated water. There was even a fatal case at Disney World in Florida in 1980, back when they had a water park built into a lake. And there are more odd cases too.
When you've got a cold and you're really bunged up in your sinuses, you can flush them out. It's really important if you're going to shove water up your nose, because of the fact that there is this amazing, these amazing nerves connecting your nose to your brain, that you use only boiled water. And so there have been cases of people who've used neti pots just taking tap water. And the brain-eating amoeba is not the only infection people have had. There are other things, but that is one potential thing people can get.
But despite the terrifying name, the grisly stories, and the 90-something percent chance of death if you're infected, infection is really rare. How much of that is down to the government warnings, though? Well, probably best not to have a control group for that experiment. Although that said, the warning signs that were once here aren't here anymore.
So what are the odds of it happening? They're very, very, very rare. The last case we had in New Zealand was, I think, in 2000. But I guess the point is, when it does happen, it's pretty catastrophic. There will be things that we're doing in our daily lives that are way more dangerous than this. You know, even from a microbial point of view, we are, covered in microbes. We have really nasty microbes kind of living in us and on us on a daily basis. And most of the time it's okay. But maybe one in four people will have Staph aureus living up their nose. Pretty fine up there, but if you get that in your bloodstream, you can end up with horrible infection. You're more at risk, frankly, from shoving your finger up your nose and then touching a cut accidentally than you are from having your brain eaten by an amoeba.
Thanks to Dr. Wiles at the University of Auckland for all her expertise. Pull down the description for the references she used in her research.